Hare Krishna. Krishna, in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, says that one's mind should be steady and intelligence should be one-pointed. If one wants to completely focus one's attention on the Supreme Lord. So the word samadhi means a one-pointed attention. And to have such a one-pointed attention, one's mind has to be steady. So he gives an example. Yata dipo nivatasto nengate sopama smritaha yogino yata yunjasya yunjato yogamatmanaha. Just like a lamp kept in a room where the windows, doors, everything is closed. So there is no wind blowing. So the fire from the lamp does not waver. It stands still. Like that he says, one's mind has to be steady for complete concentration. Like if you take a magnifying glass and focus it at a focal point, then you'll find a small circle, concentrated circle, which can burn a paper or cotton. But if you take a lens and shake like this, can it burn it? Similarly, when our mind is unsteady, then we cannot focus. It's not possible. Therefore, one has to keep one's mind steady. But the mind is like a reservoir where small ripples and bigger waves and huge tides are rising. What are these? Like the vritti, vasana and samskar. The vritti is the pravritti or our small ripples of initial desires which develop into samskaras. Samskaras means a proclivity or a tendency. I mean the vasanas. And the samskaras are even more deep, which means they are like set patterns. So, these kinds of waves are rising and not allowing the mind to be steady. Therefore, we find when we try to chant the holy name in the morning, within completing one or two mantras, mind runs here and there. Then again you pull it back, again it runs. So this is a kind of war we are waging against Maya. And many times we may fail. So how to make the mind steady so that with the one-pointed concentration we can call out the holy name and hear it nicely and nourish the soul. How it can be done? What is the root cause of the unsteadiness of the mind? If you see, the cause of the mind's unsteadiness is material desires. As material desires enter into our mind, as their count increases, number of material desires, they will extremely make the mind hyperactive. And when material desires are out, the mind becomes steady. But then how to remove the material desires? Just like if some virus or bacteria has entered into our system, they shake the whole body, correct? Whether dengue virus or viral fever or something. And after you put the antibiotics, they are driven out. Then the body becomes healthy. Now, if material desires are occupying my mind, what is the cause of that? How are more and more material desires produced and they enter into my mind without my permission? One may have a question. The material desires arise by material identification. When we identify the world around us with material consciousness, material identification, new material desires are produced. Yasyatma buddhirkuna petri dhatuke swadhi kalatra adishubhoma ijjadi yattirta buddhi salile nakarihichit janeshva bhigneshu sayeva gokaraha. Krishna is telling, what is material identification? He is telling, considering this body made up of flesh and bones to be oneself, considering the place of birth to be very dear to one's heart, and considering one's relatives and friends to be one's own, considering all this material identification is actually moha. That material identification is the cause of production of material desires. Or identifying with our material posts and positions in this world. Identifying with our wealth. Eight things are said in the Bhagavatam. Atma, Jaya, Sutagara, Pashu, Dravina, Bandushu, Rajye, चाविकले नित्यम विरूढ़ा ममताम जहौ इट इज सेड परीक्षित महाराज गेव अप दिस एट टाइप्स ऑफ अटैचमेंट्स सो दीज एट थिंग्स प्रोड्यूस मेटीरियल डिजायर्स एंड द मेटीरियल डिजायर्स ऑक्युपाई अवर माइंड देन दे आर लाइक अ गोस्ट दे मेक द माइंड वेरी अनस्टडी व्हेन द माइंड इज अनस्टडी देन यू कैनॉट फोकस इट एट वन फोकल पॉइंट व्हेन वी कैनॉट फोकस समाधि डजंट हैपन दिस इज अ मैकेनिज्म सो नॉट दैट इज वाई इफ वन वॉन्ट्स टू मेक द माइंड स्टडी then one should put oneself in such a ambience and climate where the number of material diseases will not be allowed to be increased which is the pratah kal namely the brahma muhurtam time this is a very good time for shooting down material diseases early morning time and in the night time the asuras become stronger correct in the early morning devatas are stronger in the night time asuras are stronger so if somebody is awake late night then the asuras asuric environment ambience is too much therefore we rise early in the morning which is it is like india pakistan match if it is held in india then you have a better pitch in india similarly morning pratah kal is better pitch for sadhakas rise early in the morning and then another thing we do is refrain from those things which increase our material identification keep away that is why we follow four regulative principles to the degree we follow them strictly by avoiding those abominable activities then the material identification cannot increase and by studying the shastra which is filled with naam roop guna leela of the supreme lord spiritual identification increases Oh, I don't belong to material world. I belong to Goloka Vrindavan. And my relatives, friends, they have temporary bodies, but my real relationship is with Krishna, who is permanent. I will never die. Krishna will never die. The relationship is eternal. In this way, by studying the shastra, internalizing the shastra with faith, chanting the holy name, keeping an environment conducive for non-production of further material diseases. And shooting down the existing material diseases with the help of guru sadhu and shastra a devotee can very easily progress and one of the most powerful agents in the spiritual life which can destroy the material diseases is actually the chanting of the holy name itself the chanting of the holy name and hearing of the shrimad bhagavatam these two are considered the most potent forms of devotional service which can actually do prema bhakti yaha hoite avidya vinash jate so when divya gyan hriday prakashito happens then these two effects are produced prema bhakti yaha hoite prema bhakti is produced actually if I have intense bhakti then I don't have to do any other homework automatic focus and concentration will come but unfortunately we don't have such bhakti also therefore we have to do this type of homework If somebody's heart is filled with bhakti bhav, nobody has to push them. Naturally, they will fall in love with Krishna, and instant samadhi they will get. Just like in our conditioned stage, by looking at opposite sex, one gets instant samadhi. Like that, one will get instant samadhi in Krishna if there is bhakti bhav. So we pray to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Parampara and Guru Sadhu Shastras to give us the strength during the chanting, so that. We try our best to concentrate and as the mind wanders we become humble understanding that oh I have very little control and then that humility helps us to cry out and call out beg for more mercy so that we will get the strength to face this is the way Krishna wants us to fight this battle as Arjuna was taking help of Krishna to fight the battle of Kurukshetra we have to take help of Guru and Krishna to fight the battle against the material diseases and then gradually as Pandavas won and ruled the world similarly we will also overcome the lower nature and the higher nature will be established which is all sweet all wonderful and then the chanting of the holy name will go from aparadha naam to namabhas to shuddha naam and one day we'll be able to call out the name purely and go back to Godhead harinam prabhu ki